The St. Louis Art Museum's collection of Islamic art includes works created between the 7th and 19th centuries, ranging from Spain to India.
Historically, throughout the Islamic world, the arts that have been held in highest esteem have been architecture and calligraphy. And so there is a different approach to art to what we see in the West. In the West, we tend to divide art into the fine arts, sculpture and painting, and what are often referred to as the minor or decorative arts. And this distinction really doesn't apply in Islamic art. In Islamic art, the vast majority of objects, up until relatively recent times, art objects were made to be used. And so we do not have objects which are meant to hang on a wall or sit on a shelf. Muslims believe that the Quran is literally the word of God revealed to the Prophet Muhammad in Arabic. And this is one of the reasons why calligraphy is one of the most highly esteemed arts. But that doesn't mean that all calligraphy is religious. Calligraphers learn to play with the letters, stretching them out, elongating them to achieve certain artistic effects. And calligraphy then is a type of art which we see on every type of medium, textiles, ceramics, metalwork. There is an enormous diversity then in the calligraphic arts. Early Islamic art was formed by a synthesis of the Greco-Roman tradition and ancient Persian traditions. The Greco-Roman tradition also is the foundational heritage of Western art, and hence we see that we do share this heritage with Islamic art. So Islamic art is not so foreign as many people often imagine.